Hello to you, friends. Another little walk and talk on early Buddhist concepts for a guiding meditation. In this case, we will go over through the third infinitely divine state, the third Brahma Vihara, which is mutual joy, rejoicing joy, joy in other beings' success. We have already touched upon the two others, namely Metta, universal, infinite friendliness, goodwill, loving kindness, and the second, Karuna, infinite compassionate pity and empathy. And now we come to the third, Mudita, mutually rejoicing joy. The fourth one is Upekkha, equanimity, serenity, mental balance, evenness of mind. But the third one is Mudita, mutually rejoicing joy. As we discussed already several times, then Buddhism is about cause and effect. So if one knows the cause, one will also gain the effect. So here we have a mental state, mutually rejoicing joy, that you rejoice, is happy over other beings' success in whatever aspect and regard it is. What is the cause of that? Yeah, that is actually that one copycats, one thinks of one's boon companion, one's best friend, which is easy for one because one have very nice warm feelings for one's best friend. Or it can be a childhood friend, or one's best friend at the present, or can be the Buddha, or can be the Buddha's noble forest monk that teaches the Dhamma. One rejoices in them, in their success, and say, ah, now they are happy. And in the future they will be happy also. How good, how sweet. And then this rejoicing in other beings' success, this one copycats, copy and paste to all other beings. Ideally, an infinite number of beings in an infinite distance from here, out in space, out to the other end of the universe, even though it doesn't exist, and infinitely in time, into an infinite number of new universal cycles, new kalpas, new eons in the future. It's important when one makes it infinite, because when one makes it infinite, then one makes an infinite cause, and then one also gains an infinite effect. What's the effect of mudita, mutually rejoicing joy? That is contentment, santuti, contentment, which the Buddha said was the highest treasure, because it's equally frustrating being discontent whether you're rich or poor. You can have a billion in the bank account and seven houses and four swimming pools, but you're still discontent. And then you can see the opposite case also, people that don't have much, but they're content and happy. And I know from personal direct experience, I tried to have almost nothing except this robe and my begging bowl and a razor and a spoon. And still, though this was the only thing I got, I owned to some extent, though it was actually the property of the Sangha, not mine personally, then I was content, happy as a bee can be. So it's true that Contentment is the highest treasure. It's one stop short of happiness and peace, because you stop searching when you're content, when you're satisfied. There's no urge. So it's a very high pearl, a treasure to have in your mind and carry in your heart. What then with the opposite, the discontentment, the frustration that many beings and also human beings say complain about, that they're discontent over this and that. If you look at that material state, that they can be fairly rich, have cars and so on, several houses, but they're still discontent. Why is that so? Because they are dominated by the opposite state of mutually rejoicing joy. And what is the opposite state of mutual joy? That is envy and jealousy. Very common feeling. If one is not aware of it, and one has some greed and hate still in the mind, then when one sees a person that has what one likes, this can be physical beauty, big boobs, big biceps muscles, or can be a big bank account, or large fame, or they are able to do what one likes to do. They have what one likes to have. High social position, then it's difficult not to be envious. Right there on the spot, right at the very contact with these beings. Though it was completely unfair to blame them that one has a lack of it, or urge for it at least. So it's very well seen by the Buddha, we should be very grateful for that, to see that the cause of discontentment, frustration, dissatisfaction is jealousy and envy. How then to eradicate this jealousy and envy? Yet one substitute with the opposite state. The opposite state of jealousy and envy is rejoicing joy. Very logic, huh? Instead of envious and having very much grudge towards those who have what one have, would like to have, then one rejoices that they have it, actually. Then one also get the opposite state of jealousy and envy, that is this contentment. So, when one trains it, then one should try to make it infinite. May all beings be happy. May all beings get all what they need. May all beings get here and be satisfied with what they need, here on Sri Lanka, here in Asia, here on planet Earth, here in this galaxy, Milky Way galaxy, in all galaxy, in the entire cosmos, into an infinite future. May they be infinitely happy, and may they gain whatever they need and whatever they want. One can do it in many ways, many variations. One should make one's personal variation, and one can. I change mine, my thing, rejoicing in others' joy or success. I change my stanza many times over the time, but I usually do 45 minutes in the morning, every morning, on this rejoicing joy at the moment. And before I did metta, but now I changed to mudita, mutually rejoicing joy. And the more I do it, the bigger the smile on my face becomes. So it works, actually. It increases the probability to be content in the future. And if you change it, see that there is envy and jealousy right on the spot, then one can exchange this envy and jealousy, and then one sees contentment arise right there. As soon as one rejoices in these famous, beautiful, successful, rich, intelligent, well-educated, high social position beings, and one rejoices in their success, then immediately envy and jealousy goes away and is substituted with contentment. It's okay they have it. It's more than okay. May they get more of it, whatever it is. So it definitely works. So this is one thing. Then one will be dissatisfied to the extent when one has been envious and jealous in the past. So it decumulates this accumulation of bad karma. Then it therefore increases the probability of being content in the future. So it works both acutely here now and as prevention for any future bad states of envy and jealousy to arise, and then also it reduces the accumulation one already have of bad karma on this in this regard. These are the straightforward results of this practicing systematically, this infinitely divine state. Basically, we say it's infinitely and divine because it's a state that some Brahma devas have in the Brahma Loka, one step up from level 13 to level 22, and we are level 5. So it's a fairly high state, but they always rejoice in it. So it gives access to the third Rupa Dhyana, fairly high subtle mental state actually. This gives access to that. It can in itself, this dwelling on this and in this, like in a house, one dwells in this mental state. Or you can say in a tent, one dwells in this mental state of rejoicing joy, mutually rejoicing joy. This can in itself induce third jhana. Then it gives access to the third formless jhana, which is dwelling in nothingness. Nothing exists. Sunya, voidness, emptiness. And even more subtle, very close to Nibbana mental state. It's two stops short of Nibbana, nothingness, to dwell in this state. So to cultivate mutually rejoicing joy, mudita, is by no means banal. One tends to think, this is some kind of romantic, idealistic, Buddhist, nice thought. No, it's not. There's nothing hippie about it. It's very skillful, it's very exact, very precise, very curing, and very elevating. So by no means banal, subtle, and very, very rewarding. And the Buddha say, if this state was not possible to cultivate, then I wouldn't tell you. And I can say the same now. It is possible to train rejoicing joy, rejoicing in other being success. It is possible. And since it is possible and it gives these results, presence of contentment, absence of jealousy and envy, third Rupa Dhyana, third formless Dhyana, then we should practice this result. You never go fail of it. So, I hereby, on the very spot, rejoices in that you see this video and become better to be content. And I also rejoice in that you rejoice in that I have made this video. So it's a double whopper here. And we can both of us can rejoice in that this video have been made, telling about what Buddha told us, about this very subtle, hard to see relation between mutual joy and contentment and the two opposite states, the relation, causal relation between envy and jealousy and discontentment, dissatisfaction. Because then now we have in the toolbox, in our mental training toolbox, a tool whereby we can induce, produce, make emerge, make come into being, make real the highest treasure, as the Buddha called contentment, sanctutti, being satisfied with whatever one has. This is the highest treasure. The cause of this highest treasure of contentment is mutually rejoicing. Joy. Mudita. So, may all beings, here and there, big or small, fair or foul, rich or poor, human or not, animal or not, male or female, famous or insignificant, past, present or future, may they infinitely rejoice in other beings' success. May they come to know this pearl of the infinite states, namely mudita, mutually rejoicing, joy. Of course, when one sees this person having what one craves for, whether it be fame or beauty, a richness or power or status, then one should be aware of this jealousy and envy. One should be aware of it, ideally the moment it arrives, and then there, right on the spot, right in that very moment, exchange it with rejoicing joy, the opposite state of jealousy and envy. And thereby one will experience, by direct personal experience, one will see this very unhappy, green, acid-like, eating up from within state of jealousy and envy go away immediately, and then be exchanged, substituted with rejoicing joy, and thereby contentment. Well, okay, 5 minutes after, or the next day, one sees another person having what you want. Then one becomes envious and jealousy again. Then one do it again. One substitutes this disadvantageous, detrimental, akusala state of jealousy and envy with mutually rejoicing joy, which is very advantageous, kusala. What do I mean by advantageous? And what do I mean by disadvantageous? A disadvantageous is something that increases the probability of experiencing unhappy states in the future. In the worst case, downfall at the moment of death to the fearful states of being an animal, a ghost, an angry demon, or a screaming hell being. But also, right here now in this life, to be, though well-to-do, having all things one can have, and then still experiencing this paradoxical discontentment, frustration, which seems to say to oneself and to others, "Ah, you're spoiled. Not even the best of the best can make you content." Huh? But it's not spoiled in that sense. It's spoiled in the sense that one has spoiled one's own mind by the impurity, the defilement of envy and jealousy. And just like you see the mountain up here, it's very beautiful when the slowly the mist goes up the mountains. slowly, slowly, by this practice, the tendency to fall into this jealousy and envy evaporates until it's finally eliminated and then exchanged with contentment, santuti. One stop short of happiness. May all beings there is, rejoice in all other beings, fortunate, good, advantageous, happy success. Thank you for your attention, clever consideration, and kind contribution, and may you have a very nice and content and rejoicing, infinitely rejoicing day. So, whenever you see a being that has something that can be good to have, then rejoice in it. And say, ah, how sweet, how good, how happy it is that this being have this and that. Enjoy this and that. How good, how sweet. This is the way to contentment. Thank you.
You heard Bhikkhu Sammāhita from the Cypress Hermitage on the Knuckles Mountain, Pampalela, Central Hill Country, Sri Lanka. Please subscribe to the Google group Buddha Direct and visit the website whatbuddhasaid.net. May all beings become thus happy thereby. Thank you. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the blessed Buddha. As the next Buddha, the noble Arya Ajitamiteya, will say, you can come as you like, but you pay as you go. Thank you for your contribution, and have a nice day.